Well, veterans today and a number of organizations, including Marines to Support Occupy, have been sending veterans around the country to stand between police and the protesters in 70 and more cities in the U.S. because the police have been becoming increasingly violent. And we figured that putting decorated war veterans in uniform, some of them, not everybody's authorized to still wear a uniform, but putting veterans out there, we figured would defuse the situation and control what has been police violence. We were very upset with the New York police because we found that they were taking money from the banking organizations, many of them working directly for the banks. We've developed a very severe lack of trust in our police organizations. Well, here in Oakland, a Marine veteran, two-time veteran of Iraq, Marine Corporal Scott Olsen, who was shot in the head with a rubber bullet. He's in critical condition in a hospital in California. I'm not in a position to respond openly on how I feel about this because I'm living in a country that's frankly not free enough to say this. But if police are going to be shooting at military veterans and they think that I think the police are trying to force veterans to respond, and it's the absolute wrong thing to do. This could turn here in the U.S. This could turn into a shooting war, bombs, snipers, acts of terror, and I think that's the whole purpose of this. And this is very much what went on in Oakland is an act of terror against American citizens perpetrated by police on behalf of banks. No, they're being paid to do it. I knew that the organizations, Occupy Wall Street, have been infiltrated by police. And we're expecting terror bombings. We're expecting police to do this. And this is going to get out of hand. And they're underestimating the outrage the American people have against their government at local level, at national level, the suffering by standards, Americans live very well. The American people are suffering in an unprecedented way, more than anyone ever imagines, and more than is ever reported anywhere. And Americans are coming together against their own governments at every level in ways that aren't being reported. This isn't a joke. This is a revolution. This is an uprising here, exactly as in Egypt, and it may turn exactly as in Libya. It's not that far from this, and the military is not going to stand behind this government and these police. I can certainly speak for 500,000 military that are members of our organization, and we're not standing behind a police state government against the people of the United States. We're not going to do it.